Regis. It is half-time, a first half full of cut and thrust. David Rennie's splendid 14th-minute header, left unmarked but beautifully finished, giving Leeds the advantage. Steve Grzebic helping Coventry undoubtedly in that phase with two other marvellous saves. But since then, Coventry have found some of their rhythm, but they found no luck around Mervyn Day's goal. And they still have it all to do in the second half. So at a half-time in the FA Cup semi-final at Hillsborough, it's Coventry City 0, Leeds United 1.
Cracking first half, David. You were saying before the match that you wanted an early goal from Leeds to give the game a lift, and you certainly got that.
Yeah, it's really opened the game up, Ian. It's been action-packed from first to the last minute there in the first half, and we've really got a tremendous game on hand second half, because Leeds have really defended with tremendous resolution, and Coventry have thrown everything at them.
Yeah, but the goal in itself, you know, when we can have a look at it now, you said to me at the time you thought that McGrath was a bit slack in his marking.
I think it was McGrath, Moy. I mean, it was a fierce, fast corner, and Rennie got there first. I think that it was McGrath that possibly should have been with him, but it was a superbly driven ball, very fast ball, very difficult to defend against.
Uh-huh. Well, in the early part of the game, it was all Leeds United, wasn't it? And Nick Oggie was called upon to make a couple of very good saves.
I was surprised how well Leeds got into the stride, you know. I mean, they didn't go out there looking as though, or feeling the way they played, as though they were underdogs. That was a superb cross by Ritchie. He was really impressive early on, and a magnificent save. And maybe there he would have felt that he might have been a slightly quicker bed to get that goal, but Grzebic did brilliantly.
And then after about 20 minutes of Leeds pressure, you know, all of a sudden Coventry seemed to settle.
Yeah,
that big Cyril came into the game.
Yeah, Cyril Regis had a terrific spell, really, where he was making chances for himself. And I thought that Dave, particularly, on this particular instance, stood up very well. After he's gone past Ashurst, Dave stands, waits until the last possible moment, gave very little angle, and Cyril hastily blasted it past the near post.
Yeah, but at that particular time, Cyril had two or three efforts, didn't he? And he started causing him all sorts of problems.
Yes, I mean, he's got pace and strength. And you see, Leeds have defended very deeply so that he isn't able to get a run past them. But in saying that, I think Leeds at times must start working the ball again to release the pressure from the back players.
Yeah. Okay, well, let's just go away from the action for a moment and join a man who is a very interesting spectator here today. He's Nobby Stiles, ex-Manchester United, and his son John, of course, playing here this afternoon for Leeds. And he's down in the tunnel area with our commentator, John Helm.
Well, Nobby, it must be a source of great pride for you today, watching your son playing in an FA Cup semi-final.
Tremendous, tremendous. I hope they keep the look. They're having the look, I think, at a moment slightly. And I hope he keeps going, because I never had any luck at Sheffield anyway, so I hope so.
But the game started tremendously well for Leeds, and Steve Grzebic really kept Coventry in with two marvellous saves.
I thought they settled very quickly, and I thought they played really well. And as you say, he made a great save. The game could have been over in the first 15 minutes, 3-0. But having said that, they've come back great, Coventry, and it could be 3-3.
That's right. I mean, and Leeds was living on the nerves a little bit towards the end of the first half.
Yeah, I think if you set a pace like that, though, it's got to drop a little bit, and you know, the chances, they didn't put them away. They made good saves, and then it lets the side back, and I think the passing went a little bit because they got tired. And I think if they keep working at it, hopefully it'll go just their way.
How do you see the second half going?
I don't. I'm just going to sit there on the edge of the seat and keep my fingers crossed and hope it goes from.
Nobby, thanks very much indeed.
Watching the game with his eyes closed in the second half.